I was never one of the cool kids growing up. Shocking, I know, but I think what's interesting about that and what it says about the person that I am today is that it was a conscious decision, and that I see a lot of echoes of what led to it in the flow arts world, too. Drex here from Drex Factor Poi, sharing with you the love of poi spinning and flow arts to benefit your body and brain, and today, I'm talking about why I think that being uncool is something that we all should strive for. Before we dive in, I just want to give a quick shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow DNA, Flow Fests, Flow Toys, Juggling Calling, Pyroterra Light Toys, Spin Balls, and Ultrapoi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these amazing companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. And a special thanks to the first non-business friend of the channel, Johnny Howard. Thanks so much for your support, Johnny. So I have this memory from elementary school. I think this would have been roughly the fifth grade or so. At that age, kids are starting to outgrow the fascinations of their childhood and looking toward their teenage years, and they start kind of jockeying for social position. My class was in the computer lab, and a couple kids were kind of yelling back and forth across the room about how cool such and such was. And I blurted out, "I'm not cool and I never want to be." And I swear you could hear a pin drop. That was a pretty startling admission to be made in that kind of environment, and I remember this kid, Eric, who most definitely was considered one of the cool kids at that point, turning around and simply saying, "You're the first person I've ever heard admit that they're not cool." Whether that reaction was out of shock, respect, or confusion, I never really found out, but it's also unexpectedly been something of a constant for my character my entire life, and part of why I now find myself rather baffled to be an influencer in the social media age. I think all kids secretly fear that they're not the cool kid. They're not the kid that everybody defers to, respects, or want to be. And I remember who the cool kids were, and they overwhelmingly had in common something that I knew that I did not want for myself. The quickest way to be seen as cool is to be detached, to be above it all, to be confident when others are anxious, to be calm when others are terrified, to be disinterested in many of the things that other people are interested in. There's a really weird power dynamic there, and I think it's kind of rooted in asserting social dominance through minimizing other people's interests, feelings, and accomplishments. And I found this to be utterly baffling as well as kind of unnerving. I am deeply passionate about the things that I do with my time, and the idea of somebody not having that kind of deep investment in the things that they spend their time on just struck me as being kind of sad. The things that I love with abandon. I want to learn everything there is to know about them, swim in them, drink of them till I'm drowning in them. And giving that up just to have other kids defer to me? That really seemed like a pretty lousy bargain, all told. So I decided at a pretty early age that cool was a thing that I wasn't and never ever wanted to be. I wanted to continue to love the things that I love with reckless abandon, whether they be dinosaurs, comic books, movies, history, economics, art. I never ever wanted to stop feeling that endless joy that all of those things gave me. Now let's fast forward a few years, because something really, really bizarre happened to that uncool kid. Because as it turns out, social hierarchies inherently work by having just a few people at the top and many, many more people at the bottom. And we discovered something very strange about that in the 90s and the early 2000s. When you aim your product for the cool kids, your market is small. When you aim your product towards the people at the bottom, however, you've got a lot more potential customers. And the world flipped upside down. Every major movie or TV show now is aiming for nerd culture. There's an entire ecosystem on YouTube, Instagram, and TikTok of people sharing obscure science and history facts. Showing off your geek cred now is no longer seen as shameful. That is the mainstream. So what does that have to do with my particular channel? Well, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that if you're spinning poi right now, you are not one of the cool kids in school. And yet, even among the uncool kids, there are still people that want to be cool. They enter a world of uncertain social hierarchy, and they want the prestige and respect of the cool kids. And it's even easier to get now among the many uncool kids that they happen to be surrounded by. And I still don't want to be one of them. I want to like what I like, I want to love what I love, and I have seen a lot of other poi spinners over the years come and go trying to be the cool kids among a group of decidedly uncool people. Frequently, they go about this the same way that people always have, by saying what is and is not uncool and looking down on people who don't fit into the arbitrary boundaries that they've set. Side note, one of the most frequent complaints that I see about the flow festivals is how clicky and elitist they can sometimes feel. And I really think this attempt to be the cool kids among the uncool kids has a lot to do with that. And just as when I was a kid, I have to say that I prefer being uncool. I am rabidly enthusiastic about dancing with my poi. I still love the dinosaur hall at the Smithsonian with a fiery passion. I'm working my way through the CW's reboot of Nancy Drew, and I am loving every last absolutely trashy second of it. So how am I a flow influencer? How do I have one of the most popular channels related to flow arts on both YouTube and Instagram if I am so uncool? I think it's important to remember in times like this the lesson that we learned in the last 20 years of popular media. The cool kids may seem to have the confidence and poise that we wish we had, but ultimately there are far more people that don't fit into that category. I think my content reaches so many eyeballs precisely because the uncool kids dramatically outnumber the cool kids. I've never had a viral video, and yet my channel does vastly better than many flow artists who have. I think part of that is due to consistency, but I think another big part of that is creating content that's aimed for the other uncool kids, the ones who are struggling and need help to get from point A to point B, not just trying to impress their peers. And all those flow artists trying to be the cool kids? Well, just remember how messed up that social hierarchy felt when you were one of the uncool kids. Instead of gatekeeping, try being welcoming. Instead of trying to learn the right tricks, create the thing that you want to see in the world. And if you don't have the passion to know what that is, see if you can go out and find it. And as for me, I'm still proudly uncool, and I cannot foresee a time when that'll change. I hope you'll join me in that because I feel like it's a lot more fun than the alternative. Did you get anything out of this video? Please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and share to help other people find this video and to help my channel grow. Real quick, I just wanted to throw out a huge thank you because this video would not be possible without the kind support of these wonderful people right here. These are my Flow patrons over on Patreon, and they, along with the people listed down in the description, helped to make this video and all the videos on my channel possible. Do you like poi content? Do you like tutorials, flow sessions, and vlogs on flow arts culture? Consider signing up to support my work. I want to bring flow arts to the wider world and help people connect with their brains and their bodies through prop spinning. So help me do it. Head on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and sign up. You can do that either by clicking on the card that just popped up on YouTube or by using the link down in the description. Not only will you be supporting this mission, but you'll also be able to get early access to all of my content, a vote in what content I produce in the future, and a host of other awesome rewards such as getting a special weekly poi lesson delivered to your inbox that is only available to my supporters. Go give that a look and please consider supporting this channel. Thank you in advance. What's your favorite decidedly uncool thing? Let me know down in the comments. Let's be uncool together. I'll leave a link to more vlogs that I've done down in the description, as well as up on screen if you're watching on YouTube. Be sure to get outside and flow today, and I will see you with a brand new video on Wednesday. Take care. Peace.